Welcome back, guys. My name is Chris, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look at S/4HANA and the various modules that compose it. This is all part of the introduction to SAP series that I'm in the middle of. This is video 3 in that series. So if you haven't seen the What is SAP and the SAP as it currently stands today videos, I highly recommend you check those out because this one's going to be building off of those videos. And to also reiterate, this is not a tutorial on S/4HANA, where I'm actually going to be diving into the system. That's going to be coming in later videos, as well as full-fledged courses on S/4HANA, its modules, as well as other alternative products within the SAP ecosystem. So with that in mind, let's start talking about S/4HANA, starting with just a recap on what the term means, because it's not self-descriptive, obviously. S/4HANA very briefly stands for, S stands for simple, 4 is in reference to S/4HANA being the fourth generation of ERP product. And then HANA is the name of SAP's proprietary database. Later on, I'll get into what makes HANA so much faster than some of the older database styles and the architectures for them. But the simplicity is that it's an incredibly fast HANA database and it works with the ERP system. So that's what the name means. And now let's take a look at a graphic. I'll pull that up now, just so we can look at a tier system of how the various modules for S/4HANA all fit in. Generally speaking, when you look around at articles on SAP, there's usually a relative consensus that there's two major categories of modules. You have the core modules and then kind of everything else. I would actually argue, and I prefer to look at it in a three-tier system, which is just my arbitrary opinion, but I'll explain my logic behind it and hopefully it provides some additional context for you when you're thinking about these things. So just to start off, we've got our first tier, which I would describe as the core modules. And when we talk about core modules, and again, this is entirely my opinion, this is not official canon from SAP, when you look at the core modules, it's pretty hard to argue against including the financial accounting module and the controlling module. Those were generally referred to as FI and CO and often thought of together. People just refer to them as FICO. So you might hear people saying, I'm a FICO consultant. They really just combine those two things together because there's so much overlap and integration between those two modules. Those are so predominantly used for companies that are using S/4HANA in the first place that if you're not using those, you really have to beg the question of why would you even go with S/4HANA in the first place if you're not going to be relying on FICO? And that's not just the case with SAP. If you really look at any ERP system, at their core, no matter what industry they're known for and their specialty, every ERP product at its beating heart, its core is a financial accounting system with a lot of other things that are attached onto that. So again, it comes as no surprise that FICO is really up in that top tier of core. I would also argue, and this one is harder to make a point on, but I personally believe in that first tier, you would also include sales and distribution, also known as SD. Sales and distribution, as the name implies, is for anyone that's going to be selling things. So there are exceptions in companies that may not need the SD module. For example, banks might not need it, or companies that are really just buckling down on research and development and they're not particularly selling anything, you may not need the S&D module. There's not that many companies that fall in that category. So for the vast majority of companies, they're going to rely not just on FICO, but on a module like SD. Then down from that, you get into what I would consider key modules. These are modules that are very frequently seen, and for many, many companies and industries, they're absolutely imperative to have. But I would say even historically, they're not always used. And certainly at this point in time and moving forward, there's many companies that choose not to use them, even if they do have those requirements. So I'll try to clarify that. Let's take a look at those modules, starting off with two of the most commonly used additional modules, which is MM or material management and PP production planning. So material management is really the procure to pay line. That is the acquisition of raw goods, or if you have goods that you're gonna be reselling, that entire process, as well as stocking it, inventory management, that whole thing. And then you get to PP, which is the manufacturing module. If you're going to be making anything, you would have that module if you're going to be staying within the S/4HANA ecosystem. But let's take a look at some examples where you may not use those modules. For example, if you are, let's say, a consulting company or one that's just delivering services, you're not selling any product, you don't need to stock anything, there's no real requirement for inventory management, then you might not need something like MM. And certainly, if you're not a manufacturing company, there's no manufacturing element involved, then of course you wouldn't need something like PP. Then moving on from that, I would still categorize in this area, but again, not as strongly in this tier. I would put the supply chain management module, SCM, as well as the HCM or human capital management modules. So both of these are obviously supply chain management. If you've got that requirement for supply chain management, that is a very commonly acquired module. And then when it comes to HCM, you could argue that every company has some requirement for HCM, but many choose to use an alternative app or system to manage their HCM requirements, as opposed to going with something like S4HANA's HCM module specifically. But again, it is still commonly used, at least historically, it's been a very commonly used module for companies that are going with S4HANA. So I do fit it into that second tier. Then moving down from that, you get to the third tier, which is really just all the additional modules. And it's not to say that these are used only in niche or fringe cases. If you're a manufacturing company, and many companies using SAP are, then having something like plant maintenance is absolutely common. So there are a lot of other modules in that third tier that are very, very frequently used, and they can be great for a lot of companies. So that's the basic concept. Now, there's a few additional elements I want to talk about in relation to this tier system. The first being the fact that these modules don't have to be purchased in any particular order in a, you could say, like a root system. For example, you don't need to get the top tier items to have any requirement or any ability to go on to the lower tiers. You could, and although this isn't common, I have seen clients even recently just get the HCM module. That's the only thing they get that's technically S4HANA. They don't get FICO, they don't get SD or anything else. Again, that is a very unusual circumstance. There's many reasons why I would argue that's not particularly intelligent, but some companies maybe already have an ERP setup and they just have a particular reason they want that one module, and that's all they get. And that's totally fine. In other words, you can pick and choose what you want within this module structure. Most companies are sticking with that top tier and then maybe going down into the lower tiers, but you can do whatever you want with that. Now, when you do get an individual module, like let's say again, you get HCM, one element that you should be aware of is the fact that there are elements of, let's say, HCM, and it's true for many of the other modules, where they require some other modules to be able to function at all. So an interesting aspect of that is if you got just HCM, it's not that you wouldn't have FICO at all. You would actually, or you could just say FI, you might get what's, you could consider like a bare bones skeletal structure of, let's say, FI, just what's necessary to make HCM function. So it's not like you're going to be paying for the full module, but you're going to get just the absolute barest level of functionality for that module to be able to make whatever module you've purchased function. And that's not just true for HCM. If you got MM, you would get whatever SD or FICO parts of those modules that are going to allow MM to work in the first place. And the last point I want to make here, which is going to be particularly relevant to the next video we're going to get into, is the aspect of how all of these modules compare and fit in with the numerous alternative SAP products that exist. Because there's many, pretty much for every single module that you see here, there is at least one alternative product in the SAP ecosystem. So then it begs the question of, well, why do we have these modules over here on S4HANA when you've got all these alternatives? Why is it SAP putting competing products next to each other? I'll get a little bit more into the rationale behind that later. But one thing I do want to make clear is that it's not an exclusive situation where, let's say, you're getting the HCM module, the comparative on the alternative side would be something like SAP SuccessFactors, which is for HR, payroll, etc. It's not that you have to get SuccessFactors or HCM. In some cases, companies choose to get both, and there is a benefit for getting the core module of HCM and then adding on SuccessFactor functionality to that. They can complement each other. I wouldn't say it's particularly common, but you should understand that you do have the ability to get either just HCM, like let's say you have a framework of FI, SD, MM, and then you get HCM. You could get HCM as part of that, or you could choose to not get HCM, just get SuccessFactors, or in some cases, you would choose to get HCM and SuccessFactors. And the same thing goes for many other products like Ariba, Concur. These things all have overlap with S4HANA's core components, but you can look at them as either alternatives or complements to what you're already getting within the S/4HANA framework. So that should give you a solid concept of the various components and modules that go into S/4HANA, which is really your beating heart of the SAP system. We're now in a perfect position to start diving into all the other products that live within that ecosystem. So if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. As I've said before, this is all part of an introduction to SAP playlist. So I'm going to be coming out with all the other videos over the next few weeks, and then I'm going to start diving into full-length tutorials and courses on the various SAP products. So if you're interested in any of that, please stay tuned. And with all that in mind, I hope to see you in the next video.